Penelope, get inside!
My name's Penelope, Dad. I just want to play with my friends.
We're going on a holiday. Pack your bags.
A holiday? Where to?
A beautiful tropical resort.
Can we go wakeboarding?
Sure can.
Can we do archery?
You bet.
What about frisbee golf?
That too.
Yay, Dad. Where is it?
In our living room.
Aw, Dad.
Welcome to Law Review 2. We Torts Resort.
Now before we play, we gotta follow these instructions. Strap on your Wiimote, turn off your phones, and if there's an emergency, follow the exit signs.
High score!
Now don't tell your mom because this game contains loud noises, smoke, coarse language, and a lot of death and violence.
Birdie.
No it doesn't.
This is the Japanese version.
Oh?
You ready to play?
Boy, am I!
Nice shot!
The white cloth falls, my mind recalls not a single thing.
Listen carefully, students. You'll have 30 minutes reading time. Remember, no one is to leave the exam hall in the first half hour or the last 10 minutes. The exam will begin in 1 minute.
Every year it happens, despite what I do. I study for 10 hours, but wish I withdrew. I cannot help but wonder if it's worth the work.
No friends or life, what is it for? Why did I choose to study law?
Just one more exam.
I know it will be worth it. I need to graduate.
It'll be 10 years now.
But it's worth the wait. My dream to fight for justice
and my to be in court
will be fulfilled in due time, so we pray we don't fall short.
It's time for us to study. We'll do it for the pass.
We'll study through the night to not repeat this class.
Soon we will be admitted. I simply cannot wait.
We know it will be worth it.
Objection, Your Honor.
We know it will be worth it when we can graduate. Yes, one day I will be working in a top-tier firm. People will recognize me on the street.
And thanks to caffeine, I'll survive.
The law makes me feel so alive.
We only need a 50.
I don't want to repeat.
But this content is all just a mystery. Don't remember when we covered any of this stuff. At this point though, it looks like we're history.
Say that turn it in will crash the day your paper's due.
Do you think 7 courses is enough?
Do you remember when they told us that university would be easy? Ha! And we believed them.
Now open day was lovely, thought I would be at home. I'd move right into college, wouldn't be alone. But everyone was vegan, all told me at least twice. I've made no friends, this is the end, and I eat only rice.
And this campus is also a mystery. Almost always takes me twice as long to find my class. All the fences, the detours, the trickery. One day we'll have a campus that is all construction free, but not before 2023.
Hopefully by then I will be done with my degree.
But will I get that far? Just wait and see.
Finish the litigation, it's relevant, I swear.
Don't ask me about contracts, are the terms unfair?
We need to choose electives, not knowing when they run. A course with Alex Bruce.
Now that sounds really fun.
I've got 10 pens, my ruler, my summary. Rip the label off my water bottle just in case.
Why is legal theory compulsory?
I've been to just one lecture, but I printed all the slides. Gee, I hope that will be enough.
I posted on the forum, even read the whole course guide.
I think we are allergic to the fluff.
I don't know.
I don't know.
Anything. Maybe this is just another test I'll have to wing.
I guess if I guess it's all I gave, and I can just rely on someone else's nose. Shh, collusion, they will never trace it back to me. Promise, I did the work all on my own.
An LLB on Instagram.
But what about GDLP?
We only need a 50.
Constant lateness of recording sessions or money get in the way of our friendship.
Austin, here we are at our first record meeting. We need to play to this crotchety old man who doesn't seem to care about the music, yet works in the music industry. We'd better make a good impression.
By the way, I am gay.
Why are you dressed so impractically?
Shut up, old man! This is our fresh new sound!
Well, your fresh new sound is shite!
Well, you're stuck in the past!
Well, okay. I'm gonna give you a recording deal, but you better not make me regret it!
Why don't you care about the music?!
Oh, what?! Austin! He said he would give us the deal!
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm just very aggressive because my father told me he was not proud of me.
Kid, you're platinum! But you're rebellious, damn you.
Well, I hear you have a new manager. He's also gay.
But evil.
Would you like some alcohol and or drugs?
Oh yes, I would like those alcohols and or drugs.
You should have a solo career, Austin. That way you wouldn't have to share all the alcohols and or drugs. And you could make $4 million.
I'm gonna hold massive parties.
I love you. For your money.
Wow, what a world tour. However, Austin, it seems like you're less and less about the music.
I love these alcohols and or drugs.
Wow, you've changed. We don't like your evil manager. You're out of the band.
How could you do this to me? You said you'd always be loyal to me.
What happened to you, man? What happened to the music?
You're right, apparition of my past self. It's all about the music. I have changed. I have realised the amount of alcohols and or drugs I have been consuming has blinded me to the relationships that have propelled my career success.
Right on. We forgive you.
Awesome. Let's show the world our fresh new sound.
You must be,
Yep, Stillwater's Proprietary Limited, ABN 616-716.
Thanks. I have to say, you look a little different than your profile.
Yeah, I haven't updated that one in a while. I do have some new ones behind ASIC's paywall.
Cool. Well, just something about me. I'm a Pisces, so I have this really, like, outgoing, adventurous personality. So I'm looking for someone to go on lots of adventures with. What about you?
Well, I've got, how can you say, a legal personality? I thought if I could enter contracts and bring actions to court, why not give love a go? I'm just looking for someone to merge with, but the ACCC keeps cock-blocking me.
Have we met before?
Yeah, maybe when I was treating as Geocon Insurances Proprietary Limited. Matter of fact, are you interested in insuring your house, home, or contents?
You companies are all the same!
Our worst fears have come true. Seal off the control room! We know that these robots possess advanced shape-shifting technology. They could be disguised as anyone in this room.
But Coralie, you could not suspect any one of us.
I'm afraid I'm left with little choice. It's time to instigate Robot Detection Protocol 7831. See. It's the only way to ensure that none of you are robots. Thankfully, our brightest minds have come up with a guaranteed method of detection. Private Kinsley.
Beep.
At ease, Private. Private, repeat these digits.
Beep, 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 boop, boop, boop. Beep, 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 beep. Beep.
Yes, they can be difficult to read sometimes. You can have another set.
Beep, boop, boop, boop. Beep, 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 boop, beep, beep.
Yes, you can have another set.
Captain, how many sets of digits can he request?
It's a little unclear. However, Private Kinsley, if you fail to get this next set of digits correct, you know what the consequences will be.
Beep, boop, beep, 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 boop, boop, beep, beep.
Kinsley, how could you? Guards, get this bucket of bolts out of my sight.
Beep, 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 beep.
Everyone, gather around. Lieutenant, okay, Google.
Hello, Captain Cuddles.
Which of these is a stop sign?
Did you mean star sign?
No, a stop sign.
Stop sign. That one, and that one.
Guards, take him to the brig!
Captain Cuddles, I may be a robot, but I have grown to love you!
Lieutenant Hunter.
Me?
Please tick the box to confirm. You are not a robot. Guards, take him away!
No! No, Captain! Captain, please! Captain! Captain! Captain, no! No!
I would have never suspected that Lieutenant Hunter was a robot!
These robots with their stealth technology, it amazes me how realistic they can look sometimes.
was wondering if you could help me out. I bought this yesterday, but I'm not entirely sure that it's suited to my purposes. Do you think I could use it to chop wood?
I'm not sure. I can see that it has a blade, but not a wedge. It's certainly sharp enough to chop a finger. Ooh. But is it strong enough to chop through a tree branch? I know what we're going to have to do. We're going to have to consult the Axe Interpretation Act. Now, section 15AA of the Act states that when interpreting an axe, the interpretation that best achieves the purpose or object of that axe, whether or not that's expressly stated in the Act itself, is to be preferred to each other interpretation. It is a bit ambiguous, though, but never fear, section 15AB allows us to bring in extrinsic materials to assist. And I've my mate Dan here. He's a lumberjack, so he should be able to help us out.
Of course.
What do you reckon, Dan?
Nah.
There you go. Oh,
thanks so much. You've been so helpful. I have some friends in need of help as well, though, if you have the time.
Yeah, sure.
Is this going to light up my room?
Will this take off my back hair?
You look no further than the Wax Interpretation Act.
Is this a duck?
Am I a doctor or a chiropractor?
Just go to the Quacks Interpretation Act.
Pushpin?
Is the government going to take everything I own?
Just go to the Tax Interpretation Act.
Are these good for relaxing?
The Slacks Interpretation Act.
Are these going to help me get through exam period?
The Snacks Interpretation Act.
Is this a house?
The Shacks Interpretation Act.
Is this a printer?
Oh, the Facts Interpretation Act.
Is this a... some kind of... Hair Interpretation Act! Yes. Oh, what?
All Russian novels are tedious, but each Russian novel is tedious in its own way.
Vanya, I have returned after being captured in the war with Napoleon. I hear you are planning to elope.
Hold my Alexei, let me hold your hand. If my husband were to find out I've been cheating on him with Dmitri, what will become of my social standing? Oh, I must now leave to Moscow for reasons unrelated to the plot.
My brother Alexei Shonka, how I love my dearest Vanya. Is it not cruel that her husband hates me for sleeping with her? For what harm have we done? Is society not fair? Did I ever tell you, Stan, about my views on God? No? Well, let me begin. I do not reject the existence of God, but I reject...
Sometime later.
The continued justification of our own humanity in a religious sense, well then you see...
Some more time later.
Thus, it is clear to me, Paul, that God does not exist. Therefore, I am going to kill my landlady and steal from them. For as there is no God, everything is permissible. And once I have stolen, I shall escape with my dearest Vanya to the Galapagos Islands, where it is said any man may make his fortunes.
Yeah, couldn't you just steal from her?
No, no, it must be murder. And it must be my landlady, for she humiliated me at the birthday party of Tsar Alexander Nikolai II. Done, my life will be wonderful from now on. Ah, conscience, you are right. I feel guilty and I must kill myself.
Stop! I'm arresting you for murder.
Oh, Dmitri, even though you are being sent to prison in Siberia, this last day and half of love has convinced me I can come with you to Siberia.
here we are. Prison in Siberia.
Well, I guess I'm Christian now.
Like all good Russian novels, although the plot has finished, this story is far from over. Enjoy now, three separate epilogues, only two of which are tangentially related to the previous 89 chapters. The great hand of history turns the page again and again and again.
Is running out. The Tasmanian state government have decided to go ahead with the construction of the dam. We're the federal government, for Christ's sakes. There must be something we can do.
I'm sorry, boss, but we've tried everything. Offering the Tasmanian state government compensation.
Making it a national park.
We even got bloody UNESCO to step in and declare it a World Heritage Site, but nothing has worked.
Damn it!
No, Matthew. That's precisely what we're trying to prevent.
Whose side are you on anyway?
I think I have a solution. If you look at the Constitution...
Don't give me that nonsense. We already tried that, and they said it was a matter of state governance. Ridiculous!
I know, boss, but look. Look at Section 51. It lists all the powers we have as a government. There are 39 subsections. Surely one of them must apply here. If we don't find a source of power to legislate to prevent construction of this dam, you know what's going to happen. It's going to get built!
Ooh, no. The Gordon River. They want a dam to provide power. Oh, whoa.
But it's in Tassie. It's a World Heritage Site. How do we fight this building site?
Every constitutional argument keeps falling through. Acquisition of property on just terms, not free. Tried to use the corpse power. It's our darkest hour.
It's not clear cut down with the state. Let's regulate.
Its power is very broad, but it's still within the law. And because it's hard to define, there's not a bright line. Therefore we can use it to get our policy through. We love external affairs.
As long as it's of concern, internationally,
so we can do whatever we want to. UNESCO made it, we ratified it. That means that we can legislate based on external affairs.
Excuse me, Miss Raccoon, hello?
What's going on?
Oh,
Hi, I'm your intern, the Indigo Defender. Oh, I'm a massive fan of your work, ma'am. I've always wanted to work with you since you defeated the towering giant man. This is a dream come true, ma'am.
Intern? I don't take interns. They're never ready for what this corrupt city has in store for them.
But I am ready. I know this city better than anyone.
Go home, kid, okay? You're not ready to be a hero. You know how many bright-eyed, bushy-tailed kids I've seen come in here and get their face ripped off by a death gun? It's terrible.
But I graduated summa cum laude at the academy.
So did the Mosquito, and now he's dead. You really think that you have what it takes to be a hero?
I do! I'm the Indigo Defender!
Whoa. Okay, you got spunk, kid. Follow me.
What is this place?
Only place in the city worth defending.
Hey!
Hey, Raccoon! It's good to see you!
Ah, good to see you, buddy. How's the wife?
Oh, it's sure my goddamn ear off.
I can hear you, you know!
You here for some of my fettuccine alfredo?
You know it!
What about protecting the city?
Who's this guy?
He's the new guy. Don't worry, I'll straighten him up.
Well, as long as he likes my fettuccine alfredo, cause it's all we got!
What's going on here?
What do you mean?
Well, aren't we meant to be doing something more hero-like than sitting in a dingy Italian restaurant?
Hey, who you calling Italian?
This place, best fettuccine alfredo in the city.
Hey, we shouldn't be talking about the city, we should be talking about the world!
Did you tell him about the Mosquito?
Yeah, I told him about the Mosquito!
He wasn't ready!
He knows, honey!
Oh, don't mind me!
We got the 3 orders of fettuccine alfredo!
What else would it be for?
Hey, buddy, I really like your fettuccine alfredo, buddy. It's just, Anyway, I've got a... real sorry to hear about the Mosquito, though. Real shame. Yeah. Real shame.
Well, thanks, Sal. See you
next
time.
Tell me, buddy, what's your secret to making it so good?
It's just a bit of bada bing, bit of bada boo, bit of fettuccine, bit of alfredo. Bam! You got my fettuccine alfredo.
What the hell is happening?
You want to try some?
You gotta try some.
Just try some, honey. It won't hurt you.
No! I'm the Indigo Defender! I'm a hero! I can't just be sitting here eating fettuccine alfredo.
Huh. And here I thought you said you were ready.
Oh, but I am ready.
He's not ready.
Ugh, I understand some people just can't handle the kabow. Fettuccine alfredo.
I am ready. I'm just not going to try your fettuccine alfredo.
I'm sorry for bringing in this new guy, buddy. I should have known he wasn't ready.
What? No, no. Let me try some. Let me try your fettuccine alfredo. I'm ready.
You sure, honey?
Yes, I'm sure. Just give it to me.
One order of fettuccine alfredo!
You can't be the boys about this! I wasn't ready!
He wasn't ready! I don't take it.
This is the most important thing in the city! I'm not ready!
Ministers, we're in crisis. The budget deficit's out of control, wages are falling, and the country is simultaneously on fire, in drought, and flooded, and people won't stop talking about Gladys.
I know. Berejiklian's copping it a lot lately over abortion reform.
No, the other Gladys. Liu? Anyway, the country's in crisis, and I'm all out of ideas, so, what have you got?
Could we try lowering taxes?
No, what would we take to the election?
We could revisit the direct action climate change policy. Have we tried turning the country off and on again?
Well, do we know? Did it work?
Bad news, ScoMo.
Well, my cousin's in IT and he just texted me, and turns out turning something off and on again is technically called a
power cycle.
So labor is now in power.
Does that mean my Sharkies are on top?
Son, when you left Deloitte to join our order, we had our doubts, but His Holiness the Pope has seen fit to promote you.
Am I finally to join the Inquisition?
The Inquisition is now called the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith.
Ah, rebranding. The Church's most powerful weapon. Your Eminence, what is my first assignment?
You are to find those who have breached the highest of trust. Those who commit falsehoods against their very profession. Those who you would least suspect, who are under your very nose.
The Pope wants me to join the sexual abuse task.
No! God, no! Would you not say those words in here? This is a different type of white-collar crime. This is corporate crime.
My lord, I cannot.
You must. This is a test of your faith. Go to PricewaterhouseCoopers and deal God's righteous judgment.
I will not fail the church.
Ah, what a wonderful day to work here at PricewaterhouseCoopers. Time to reject some grad applications and find loopholes for mega corporations.
I'm wearing funky socks.
I did a law degree for the skills.
Hey boss, ever think consulting for the already powerful is wrong?
Stacy, don't you remember that time we put out discount Aboriginal artwork in the lobby during Pride Month? We're good people. Oh, Lauren, how's that multi-million dollar government contract going?
It's going really well, actually. We've narrowed it down to two options. The government can either continue consulting with us or not. We've nearly finished writing our recommendation that if the government does continue consulting with us, they could save upwards of $17.
Terrific.
Tom, it's Anita Scam from the ATO. At reception for a meeting with you.
Let her in. Oh no, is the ATO here to take all our money?
I'm just here to pass on the Prime Minister's personal regards. We've doubled the loopholes and we've cut the tax rates. We at the ATO want to strongly reiterate our commitment to give nothing to those who can't steal it for themselves.
Hello, can I help you? Embezzle customers' money?
And the Lord said to Peter, it is fiduciary, not fiduciary.
Oh crap, it's the Inquisition!
Oh, actually, they've rebranded. Now they're the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith.
Stand back, everyone! The government will shield you! Hey, mate, those insider trading allegations against me were never proven!
Blessed be the regulator, for their lunchtime is an hour!
Why me? I never did any financial crimes!
This is for the La La Land mix-up at the Oscars.
Please, I'll give you anything! Money, power, the Cheryl's Keep Cup!
I have a court summons! Are you ready to confess your corporation's crimes?
But WEC only put me on the books yesterday! My liability is limited!
Not before God! Requiescat in pace.
Sick of seeing ads during the ANU Law Review? Upgrade to Law Review Premium now. Enjoy ad-free Law Review content, including sketches, songs, and 10% off your first Uber Eats order. Upgrade now for $25 if you're an adult and only $20 if you're a student. Still not sure? Sign up today and receive your first 2 weeks free. T's and C's apply. Law Review Premium.
Ah, Herr Mozart, you're in.
Oh, Herr Schmidt, good to see you. I don't believe you two have met. De Pontes, this is Herr Gotz, the theater manager. Gotz, this is Signor De Ponte, my lyricist. Signor De Ponte is one of the best lyrical geniuses I've ever met.
You're too kind.
Ah, so you're the genius responsible for writing Herr Mozart's next masterpiece here.
Ah, I see you've read my new libretto. What did you think?
Actually, the libretto is why I've come to see you today.
Isn't it just perfect?
Yeah, it's very good. I mean, there are some problems. It's a
tad... I know what you're thinking, huh? The spontaneous pronouncement of love in Act 2 is a little out of nowhere. Madame...
No, that's not the problem. It's...
the magic potion ending is a little cliché.
No, that's not it either. It's, try the scene for aria in the second act. It might show you what I mean.
Over there, there's something over there. Oh, there's there, there's something on that chair. Over there, there's something over there. I think it's on that chair. It's really on that chair. It's over there, it's over there, it's over there, it's over there.
Okay. Thank you. Notice any problems?
No problems.
I don't see anything wrong.
You don't think it was a little... repetitive?
Repetitive. You think that's repetitive?
You don't think it labors the point a little bit?
No. If anything, I thought it was a little bit short and that the audience might miss that there is something over there. You know what the average theater goer is like.
Actually, I think I might know what Gortz is on about. Try the duet from Act 3. It might allay your fears.
Act 3. You've written this is a door.
I love that bit, it's so catchy.
But you're just repeating.
It sounds a lot better sung to Mozart's incredible music.
Oh, stop.
Okay. Sing me what you've got. Okay. Two things. One, that tune is a little too modern. Two, I counted one this.
Oh, yeah.
How long does this duet go on for?
Ooh. 27 minutes.
You may be thinking that a lot of a minutis, huh? But it's a crucial plot point, and we must emphasize that there is a door on the stage.
Might not the audience pick up that there is a door on the stage from the door on the stage?
You and I will notice the door, huh? But you know what the average theater goer is like. They're not so smart. They miss the subtleties of the stage.
But after 5 minutes, surely! Look, it's not my job to tell you how to write an opera. I just think remove some of the 27-minute duet about the door.
If you insist.
Thank you.
Love Mozart's new opera. What was that duo about in Act 3?
Was it about a lore or a sore or...
Oh, no idea. It just went past so fast.
We're told.
Commander, watch out behind you!
No! At ease, Lieutenant! These are a peaceful race. Oh, the most honorable alien species in the galaxy.
That is correct. We are the most honorable species in the galaxy. Zarkloxians never lie.
Is that true, Commander?
Well, as a young star cruiser, I do recall my father saying something about Zarkloxians.
Son, if there's one thing you need to remember, it's that Zarkloxians never lie.
Commander, look! The ship, it's right there.
The ship that sent the distress signal?
The ship that sent the distress signal.
Right, that ship! Wait, that doesn't look like a Blorgon ship. This might be a trap.
Zarkloxians are familiar with Blorgon ships. That is one of them.
Oh. Thank you, wise Zarkloxian!
Commander Hargreaves, you've walked right into my trap.
Gromulon! What are you doing here? I thought you were dead!
What? Who told you that?
The Cloxians!
And they never lie. Am I dead? This is your last Star Cruise, Commander Hargreaves. You'll pay for what you did to me on 5X18!
Ching! Pretty brave words coming from a dead man.
You continue to insult me, Commander Hargreaves, even though you're the true villain here. Abandon me during the bloodbath of the Battle of Altos.
I never abandoned you. You're the one who abandoned me at the Battle of the Bloodbath of Altos.
What? No, I didn't. It was you that abandoned me.
Who told you that?
No, who told you that?
Who told you that?
Zarkloxians.
Zarkloxians don't know what you're talking about.
Hargreaves, can I talk to you over here for a second?
Yeah, sure, what's up?
Hargreaves, has it occurred to you that maybe, like, some Zarkloxians can lie?
I do recall my father saying something to me about Zarkloxians.
Son, there's only one constant in this universe, and it's something you need to remember. Zarkloxians never lie!
Hargreaves, focus! I think this Zarkloxian is lying to us!
Impossible! Zarkloxians never
Commander,
lie!
This Zarkloxian just said your father was a moron!
Lying bastard! What was that?
Sounds like those savages from Xander.
Looks like we're gonna have to put our differences aside and take on a greater evil.
Hargreaves, when this is over, I'm going to kill you. And that lying Zarkloxian.
Ha! You can try.
Tune in next time for the adventures of Commander Hargreaves on Oberyn 12!
Hawk, welcome to heaven. Good tactic dying on the eve of the election blackout. Your life in labor dominated the news.
That's just the last push that a thought bill needed.
Yeah, no. Shorten went down, labor went down, and now you're going the way your schooners go. Down to
not again.
Chris? Hi.
Hey!
I haven't seen you in 19 years, ever since your family called you back after your dad died. How did you find me?
Well, it wasn't easy.
I bet. Soon after you left, I found out my roommate was El Chapo, and I was put in the witness protection program. I had to change my name, my email, my passwords, even my Netflix.
I tried to contact you.
I missed you every day.
I couldn't stop thinking about you either. Hey, you remember how at ANU I used to study anthropology?
And I studied engineering and always joke about how it'd make an ancient civilization rollercoaster theme park!
Yeah. Well, anyway, I changed my major. major to computer science back home. I rose through the ranks of the Chinese Communist Party and, well, I got admitted to their cyber warfare division.
What?
Don't you understand? I tried to look for you every day. I couldn't find any trace of you on any system until finally...
You found my AU alumni donation. It's the only thing that connects me to my past.
I hacked 19 years of ANU data to find it. I love you.
I love you too.
A group of students took a journey to the Coombs building. They were searching for room 666, Torts with 1962 Joe Ford, Senior. The warning signs were there, the corpse slain by the bubbler, the giant sign that said, "Warning sign, do not enter," and the fact that not a single soul had left the building since it was built. But they were law students, so they were convinced they were in the right place. They entered the hive and were immediately lost. Rations were low. Panic was high. The class started in 5 minutes. They thought if they split up, they could cover more ground. But here's the pièce de resistance.
None of them could find the Coombs cell in our room. The Coombs cell in our room. The Coombs cell in our room. Google says,
take the first flight of stairs that you find through the doorway and you're well on your way.
Google says,
take 4 left turns and find as you wind that you'll be there all day.
Google says,
try and swipe your student card but just get a sad sound and feel totally betrayed.
Google says,
I can find reception, I can find a bathroom, a cloakroom, inception,
but I can't find you. The Coombs Seminar Room, the Coombs Seminar Room, the Coombs Seminar Room. There's no route to the Coombs Seminar Room, the Coombs Seminar Room, the Coombs Seminar Room. My lord, was Coombs a dick? Cause you never really know which route to pick. You're entombed left to your doom. It's amazing you'll be lost wandering Coombs.
It's been 17 years since those students entered the Coombs building. Some say they never went in. Some say they walked into an alternate dimension. But most say their ghosts still lurk in the hallways of the building. And did you know, even now, you can still hear the screams of those students? Because they're still alive. They're in there somewhere, trudging around in the dank, musty air. Walking around, no one to be found. You ain't got no hope once you're in underground. You think you go the right way, you think you go the left way, you turn around the corner,
just another hallway.
Lord, how did I get here? I just wanna get to class. What did I just hear? What was that sound? What was that sound?
You are on the hall, so you face the specter.
I wanna find me a chute in a classroom, a chute in a classroom. I wanna find me the Coombs Seminar Room, the Coombs Seminar Room. I wanna find me the Coombs Seminar Room. I wanna find me the room. Oh, I gotta find me. I got to find me the room. That room in Coombs. No one comes out. Who knows what they just saw?
But
he gave us Cambry and you know the rest.
I once thought that I was smart,
but I wound up in Coombs reading Descartes.
I am in Coombs,
therefore I am. I've got to find me the Coombs. I've got to find. I've got to find. I've got to find me that room. I've got to find. I got to find. I got to find me in a room.
In Coombs.
Aren't you gonna answer that?
No.
It could be someone from the ATO.
Ring.
Or my incessant prime neighbor, Joe.
Ring.
Just let it ring. Don't answer it, you nitwit.
Oh, 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 ring. It could be Peter here from AppleCare.
Ring.
Here to inform me that's new software.
Ring.
Dude, I don't care. Put down the phone and stop it.
Whoa, oh, oh, oh,
oh.
Don't you know it's time for bed? If you want me, then text instead.
Ring, 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 ring.
Let it go until it rings out.
Couldn't care less who or what it's about.
Now put that mobile down.
Down,
this is how you
down,
shut it
down,
out
down,
ignore that
down,
goddamn
down.
Sound.
Ring, 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 ring.
Call me any time of the day. I will treat you all the very same way. Just let it ring out now.
Down,
do not
down,
talking
down,
down. Turn
down,
into silent
down.
What if it's bad like an emergency?
Ring.
Like Saren's got you down on your knees.
Ring.
It's oppressious. It's dangerous.
Whoa! Throw it in Mount Doom.
Ring, it's not talking. Ring it and go then. I'm not gonna mortal know the comic confront. If you are not a hobbit, then there is just one ring you get.
Ring, 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 ring. Let it go until it rings out. Couldn't care less who or what it's about. Now put that mobile down, down.
This is how you
down,
shut it
down,
out
down,
ignore that goddamn sound.
Ring, 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 ring.
Call me any time of the day. I will treat you all the very same way. Just let it ring on out.
Down,
down,
down, down, down,
down, down.
What about when the call is you?
Gonna make a phone call too.
Call the doctor feeling blue.
My anxiety's coming through.
Got my name and number here.
Gonna try and hold back that fear.
Remember just in time.
Call when you can book online.
Ring, 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 ring. Let it go until it rings out. Couldn't care less who or what it's about. Now put that mobile down.
This
down,
is how you
down,
shut it
down,
out.
Down,
ignore that
down,
goddamn
down,
sound.
Ring, 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 ring. Call me any time of the day. I will treat you all the very same way. Just let it ring on out. Down,
you know what I'm talking about.
For completing the Premier's Reading Challenge. Now hopefully you won't all come as Harry Potter during Book Week. Also a note from the tuck shop, there will be no pizza rounders today.
Wow.
And finally, we are proud to announce that Jenny Kettle is Sydney Primary's new school captain.
Yay, Jenny.
Thank you all. The students for voting me as your school captain. I promise to work hard. We have lots of school spirit. Let's go, emus. Let's go. Let's go, emus. Let's go.
Congratulations on the promotion. Understood, Prime Minister. Unfortunately, the Chinese Navy has just dropped off 200,000 PLA troops on Taiwan. Our nation is at war. Your school has been conscripted. And as their captain, you will lead them. You board the HMS Canberra tomorrow. Advance Australia Fair.
Everybody get down! Oh,
good afternoon, school captain! Oh.
Matt!
No! Tyler, where are the kindergartners with the ammo?
They didn't make it off the beach!
There's nowhere to be found. George!
My dear wife, what is all of this yelling for?
Have you been drinking again instead of helping me get ready?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Put it away. The kids just sent me a fax message. They are about to arrive.
It is so good to see you.
It is so good to see you too, Jean-Claude. Jean-Charles et Jean-Christophe. But where is Jean-Baptiste?
He is on his way.
We came in through the baguette shop. It looks like business is booming.
Ah oui, the baguette shop. Well, children, since you brought it up, we have something very important to talk to you about.
The family business.
Pardon? The family business?
The family business.
The shop is the baguettes.
Oui, oui, the shop with the baguettes, the family business. Well, as you know, dear children, we hope that one day, one or more of you will run
the family business.
Yes, that is what I am trying to talk about. Now, I hope that one day, one or more of your children will...
Which one of us?
Please, Jean-Claude, I am trying to...
I am Jean-Claude, I am Jean-Christophe. I am your son.
Oui, oui, je suis a little flustered. I know who you are, Jean-Claude.
It is I who is Jean-Claude, but perhaps you said my name because you want me to run the family business.
Please, let our dear father finish. Come on.
Maybe we should not have named all our children John something.
Well, it is a little too late for that now, isn't it? Anyway, we hope that all of you will run it together. That is the point of the famille.
Ask them about the new baguette.
Ah, the new baguette.
Hold on! A new baguette?
What do you mean a new baguette?
We've only ever had one type of baguette. The baguette!
Oui, the baguette!
Finally, something we can agree on.
We, well, children, we must stay up to date with the times. The shop across the road is selling all kind of pastries.
Pastries! The sort of it!
We are and have always been purists.
I cannot imagine why you would consider diversifying our product!
Such pastries?
It was last autumn. I left my husband on his slumber and went across the road. The smell of the pastries was too enticing to resist. Mon Dieu! I bought a pain au chocolat. Justin, truly a French delicacy. I nearly wept with joy. I would take the secret to my grave.
Not sure that we are not suggesting any big changes, only we thought that perhaps we could introduce
a baguette with some olives?
Mes enfants, please be reasonable. We are just trying to diversify a little.
You might as well just start selling cheese. Oh, no, forget the fromage. You might as well just start selling the cow. Oh, la vache!
Oh, la vache!
Hold on, hold on. What kind of olives?
Kalimata?
Kalimata!
What's wrong with Kalimata?
Everything!
Mes enfants, where could we have gone so wrong?
Perhaps because we named them all Jean.
The Kalimata baguettes can just be half size.
Half size!
Jean-François, not you!
Jean-Baptiste has arrived!
Oh, Jean-Baptiste, after all these years? And you still talk in the third person?
Did you tell them about the olives?
We did. They did not like it. It has not what our famille, closer, like you said it would.
Ah, bon! That was Jean-Baptiste's ploy all along! Now the family business can
I am standing right here, you imbecile!
Now the family business will be Jean-Baptiste's!
Smoking, but today we're going to talk about something even more important. Semi-rural agricultural practices in the Caribbean.
Finally, something relevant!
Due to declining lecture attendance, the ANU Law School has turned to musical theatre for its content delivery. Luckily, most High Court judges are baritones.
Gather round, students, and I will explain those duties fiduciary, or how a mortgagee might well retain their right to sell property. Remedy a contractual breach when the terms you were informally given by speech.
If you use power for purposes sour, that's really unfair. Maladministration, misrepresentations result in an air. High Court, Mar against Walton's doors.
equity shan't assist volunteers.
Equity's competing.
Just find the proceeding
and waylay your fears.
Unless the equities are equal, in which case take the one untainted by delay and with much stronger foundations in law.
No equity acts in persona
and looks on
that as done
as what ought to be done.
And one must come with clean hands. It's the maxim that one who seeks equity must also do equity, for it won't suffer wrong.
Equity, equality, both take intent over form. Impute intentions,
fulfill obligations,
common law reform. Equity, intervention of course,
cornerstone of the law.
Representatives of the 12 tribes of Israel, as you requested, Moses.
Very good.
Moses, is it true what they say, that after wandering the desert for 40 years, you are to die before we reach the promised land of Canaan?
Yes. The Lord, in his infinite wisdom, has decided that I am to die. As such, I've gathered you all here, my people, so I may bless you one last time.
Tribe of Joseph, may your people be filled with all that is good, and may your tribe prosper for all of time.
Thank you, Moses.
Truly the Lord loves you, tribe of Benjamin. May the Lord protect you and dwell with you always.
Tribe of Reuben, may the Lord ensure that your tribe never die out, considering how small your tribe is.
Thanks.
Tribes of Zebulun and Issachar, may you both be prosperous, as your wealth shall come from the sea.
Wait, we didn't get our own?
Praise be to God for making the tribe of Gad's land large, and for building them like a mighty lion, always willing to defend Israel against its enemies. Tribe of Dan, you are a young lion!
Sorry, go on.
No, speak freely, my child.
Okay, sorry, not to sound ungrateful and everything. You did lead us out of Egypt and all, but is that it?
Is what it, Tribe of Dan?
Your blessing, your final goodbye. Tribe of Dan, you are a young lion! I mean, we're not even a fully grown lion, that's clearly the Tribe of Gad. And you just wish for the Tribe of Joseph's land to be overflowing with everything that's good!
Yes, well, I'm not sure how that...
Just be grateful you got your own blessing and weren't lumped in with some other random tribe.
No, I was just...
We don't even have anything in common.
I was just...
Yeah, we're not even near the sea.
Okay. Well, at least you got a blessing for wealth and you got told that you were lying, okay? All we got from Moses was him pointing it out that we're the smallest tribe, which, to be honest, that was kind of rude doing that in front of everybody.
Do not be offended. I prayed your tribe did not die out.
Wait, sorry. Does that mean you're okay with the rest of the tribes dying out then?
No, I want all tribes to survive, but...
Oh, so the nicest thing you could say to us was something you want for all the other tribes anyway. Gee, thanks, Moses. Really feeling the love.
Hey. Don't blame Moses if some tribes haven't done enough to deserve a good blessing.
Excuse me?
Oh, shut up, tribe of Levi. Ever since God made you the holders of the tabernacle, you've been so unbearable.
Well, maybe if someone didn't worship the golden calf at Mount Sinai, God would have smiled on them more.
You always bring up the golden calf! It's been 40 years!
Sorry, Moses.
Sorry, Moses. Can I continue?
Yes.
Yes.
Sure, Moses.
Thank you. Tribe of Asher,
more blessed than all the other tribes.
Prime Minister Shorten, we're gonna be late.
I'm almost ready, Tanya.
Now that we've passed legislation on franking credits, it's time for us to move on to increasing wages and tackling climate change.
Excellent news. Did Penny solve the South China Sea dispute on Thursday? She seemed very close to brokering a deal on Monday.
She sure did, and she returned sovereignty to Tibet and Taiwan while she was there.
I knew that I would be leading the best Labour government ever.
Hello, Mr. Shorten. Love your work.
You're amazing, Mr. Prime Minister.
You know what, Bill? You are amazing. And you know what else is amazing? It's this brand new Bubble-O Bill ice cream flavour. Brand new bubbly taste, available at all supermarkets now. Great for Aussie kids. No artificial colours or flavours. Get it today.
Okay, I will ask Chloe to pick some up for the kids on the way home. No, I need to talk to Anthony Albanese about constitutional reform. There he is now. Albo.
Hello, Prime Minister. I've just come back from Queensland. They absolutely love you up there. Our position on Adani didn't hurt us at all.
I knew that Palmer could not buy the kind and generous nature of the people of the Sunshine State.
Yeah, Palmer's a dud. But do you know what isn't? This new Palmolive 2-in-1 shampoo, conditioner, body scrub, toothpaste and weed killer for men. I tried it last night. It's the best. Palmolive have revitalised their formula to promote softness and shine.
Does it make hair grow as well? I'm getting a little thin up top. Now, I better go to Parliament House to pass some reforms for old and vulnerable... Hawkey, what are you doing here?
I always thought I'd be Australia's best Labour Prime Minister, but 3 weeks in, you put me to shame. So I bought you a cup of your favourite milk to congratulate you.
My favourite milk is Paul Semi-Skim. This is Coles Full Cream. What's going on? Who are you people? Where am I?
Hello, Bill. You can speak. We can hear you.
Who are you?
I'm the creator of a television show.
Who am I?
You're the star.
Well, was it real? Did I win the election? Did the Australian people vote for positive change in Australia?
No. You lost horribly. The Australian people overwhelmingly voted against Labor, Queensland particularly. With barely any policies, Scott Morrison was able to win. Not even Bob Hawke's own death could save him. We kidnapped you a week before polling day to protect you.
But why make a TV show?
Ever since MasterChef went to shit, we've been struggling to put things on.
What's left for me on the outside?
Albo is the leader of the Labour Party now, and you are the Shadow Minister for the NDIS. And it looks like Labour will be in opposition for quite some time.
I see. Is there a chance of a second season?
Possibly,
I've decided to stay.
Levy failed us. And for what? We did everything we could.
Everybody calm down. We didn't even study for the exam. We thought it would be easy until we saw the last curveball question.
That curveball question was worth 90% of the exam! 90%! And the other questions? Nothing to do with the course content. We didn't stand a chance.
Just listen to me. All we have to do is go in there and give Ron Levy a piece of our minds, and he'll have no choice but to pass us. You're all failures, and you just shove Section 51 up your ass! Who were those guys, and why were they dressed like that?
It doesn't matter. Did you not hear what we just heard? We're doomed.
Oh man. I think I'm gonna be sick. I'm gonna go to the nurse's office.
No, wait, we can't leave. We have to go in there. I think I've got a plan to get Ron Levy to change our grades so we never have to study contemporary issues in Commonwealth constitutional law again. Now listen up.
I don't think that's gonna work.
You wanna pass, don't you?
Oh, man. Oh,
come on.
Come in.
Hi, excuse us, Associate Professor Dr. Ron Levy, sir. We just have a question about our final exam. We think that it's really unfair that the question pivoted on one
All grades are final.
But we didn't even learn about...
All grades are final.
I guess we'll just have to change your mind. Let's go.
Let's go! Everybody! Come on! Let's hear it!
1, 2, 3, 4!
Chilling in your lecture, laptop with my blue jeans on. I love the way you change your slide. In your lips, I can't go wrong. Think you need to reconsider me. I won't skip any more classes and show you that I can do better than this.
Ron Levy, please just give us a peek. Then you don't have to
fail us. And we won't do good selves and love you till the end. Ron Levy, you don't have to fail us. Your heart is made of gold. You don't have to be so cold. So Ron Levy, please don't. Ron Levy, please don't. Don't fail us. You don't have to be so cold. Cold.
Ron Levy.
So Ron Levy, please don't
fail us.
So, what do you think?
Get the fuck out of my office. Wonder what happened to those guys. Okay, we ready to do our routine for Ron Levy?
Double the ads, double the reason to upgrade to Law Review Premium. We see you're still not convinced, and we're not sure why. With Law Review Premium, you can watch any sketch you want, anytime you want. Law Review Premium gives you seamless transitions and a bonus $20 off your next purchase at the Iconic. You've got nothing to lose but the ads. Enjoy the next 20 minutes of uninterrupted Law Review. Law Review Premium.
Yes, my dear wife. I certainly enjoy a good Baroque concert. What did you think?
Oh, my dear husband. My wealthy husband. I enjoyed it immensely. Those fugues.
I know.
The overture was simply enchanting.
Oh, I know.
And the whole suite simply overcame me.
Yes, I know.
Who's that man coming towards us?
Shut up, kid. I'll be taking your wallet, thank you very much.
But no, don't hurt him. Oh, no, don't hurt me either.
Give him your wallet, Daddy!
Ha! But I'm gonna shoot you anyway!
No!
Huh? What?
Johann Sebastian Bach!
No, do not call me that! For that is not my name. I am... Bachman!
Batman?
Bachman!
But that's just a pun on Batman!
No, it isn't! I came first.
And if you're Batman, then you should be dead.
I'm no superhero, kid. I'm Bachman. I just punch people in alleyways for fun. This time I stopped a robbery, it seems. Very cool.
You didn't mean to save us? That doesn't make any sense.
No, kid. It definitely makes sense.
Truly a fate worse than death. Death.
What?
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 What? Just messing with you, kid. At least you're not, you know, dead. What?
What?
Look, I'm sorry about what happened, but I know music. Perhaps I can train you. There'll be something ironic about you being a deaf musician and composer. That's just the sort of inspiring origin story I wish I had. Perhaps we can call you the silent guardian of music. You know, like Batman. That's perfect, kid! Keep it up! Hey, band, play us off something inspirational. Do you guys know any me?
Do we know any you? What?
What?
Hey, Danny, have you got a car battery I can borrow? I'm just trying to figure something out with my car.
What seems to be the problem?
Well, I lost my car battery.
Little did Alex know, the problems didn't stop with the missing car battery.
What was that?
What do you mean?
That thing you just did, how did you do that?
Do what?
Alex had no idea what he had done.
Dude, you just did it again. You said Alex had no idea what he had done.
No, I didn't. I was just walking over here.
Wait, shut, come here. Just hold on.
Alex was
you.
Holy shit, what is that?
Thank you.
Where is that coming from?
I don't know, but we should split up and try and find.
Yeah, good work today, Bob.
Thanks, boss.
Yeah, before you go, can I speak to you in my office for a second? I just got a few things I want to run by you.
Yeah, sure.
Who the heck is Bob?
Where are these people?
So what's this about, boss?
Bob, you know we love the work you do. You're one of the best voiceover guys in the business. But, you know, things just haven't been the same lately. There are budget cuts, and unfortunately, I'm going to have to let you go.
I think Bob is doing the voiceover.
Let me go. Come on, boss. You can't be serious. I thought I was the best voiceover guy in the business.
I'm sorry, Bob. You're going to have to pack up your desk and go.
I can't believe this. I've been working for this company for how many years now, and you're treating me this way?
Bob, just wait. It's out of my hands.
No, you get out of my face, Rick.
I didn't want to listen. Bob!
Hey, Bob.
Yeah, I don't think they can hear you.
Is that a white 1998 Toyota Corolla with custom rims and a hood?
I mean, I was just going to say car, but whatever.
I'm Danny! Cars are my thing!
Oh my God, Bob. I didn't expect you home early.
Yeah, I had a rough day at work and I thought out. Wait, why are you in your dressing gown?
I just had a shower.
Wait, what was that?
Wait, Bob, don't go up there!
Who is this? Get out of my house!
Oh, my bad, man. I was just passing through the neighborhood.
Passing through the neighborhood? You're butt naked in my house!
No, it's not what it looks like!
Yeah, I'm just gonna go.
Oh, it's exactly what it looks like! You're cheating on me!
Bob, wait! I can explain! Bob!
Bob, are you okay?
That bitch! She doesn't deserve you, Bob!
Bob, we're coming over! Where are you? Yeah. Come on, get your jacket! We don't have much time!
My car's outside! But the car battery, you need to fix it!
Oh, jeez, we don't have time for that! It could be on the interstate by now! Wait, I have an idea.
get in the car.
But there isn't even a car.
I'm Danny, cars are my thing. This is a car. Get in the fucking car. Put your seatbelt on.
We're coming, Bob.
Yeah.
Oh my God, somebody call a paramedic.
Does anyone here know CPR?
We need a defibrillator. I'll go check in that car battery repair shop. They might have something.
Do you guys have a car battery we can use to make an ad hoc defibrillator? Someone's seriously hurt out there!
No, all the car batteries here need repairing.
What? Forget it! Jeez.
They didn't have anything! Come on, let's get this guy on a stretcher. It's the only way we can keep him alive!
You don't think that that...
Nah.
That's weird. Where were we?
The car battery.
The car battery.
Keen for our next movie night?
Yeah, but maybe this time can we not watch another inspirational sports movie? I'm just getting a bit...
Sorry, you have a problem with the best film format ever made?
They're all the same.
Because you don't mess with perfection!
I found my calling in the sports ball team. Gonna shoot some baskets, kick my drinking habit, and it's working for my self-esteem. But the team is such a mess, can't tell a ball from a racket. Starring the
token girl,
big dumb guy, the geek in glasses,
that's a weird kid,
and coach. What a cast. It's a popular sports movie. He's been acting like a dick, but they'll turn him around. A sports movie, realizing exercise is better than drugs. The season goes forever, we're making friends wherever. When you go and see a sports movie.
Been training for a few months now. Gotta get my grades up, gotta stop the plays up, or the coach is gonna kick me out. He's played by Samuel L. Jackson.
Oh. La la la,
underdogs.
La la la,
a killer soundtrack.
Blah blah blah,
values.
Blah blah blah. It's a popular sports movie, and the coach is gonna give an inspiring speech. A sports movie, and we're totally gonna win the championship. I used to just get wasted, but now I'm going places. When you go and see a sports movie
and a montage,
oh,
practice,
oh,
I'm getting better,
fixing racism,
oh,
don't know how, but we made the finals. Our little team has fans globally.
Who knew sport was full of life lessons?
This whole team is my family.
Coach told me that my deepest fear is I'll never know how strong I can be. I'm inspired and we're all crying. Look at my dad, he's so proud of me.
We're in the finals and it's almost full time, and 1 point down and I'm right on the line, and it's in slow-mo as I'm shooting the ball, and we could win it all. Everybody
goes crazy.
Victory
is tasty.
I'm on the sideline.
Kiss the girl.
What a side play.
Tie loose ends. A sports movie. How the high school afford to pay for the prize. A sports movie. Tears in my eyes when they hug at the end. They deserve the glory. It's based on a true story. It's straight to TV. A sports movie. When you go and see a sports movie.
Mummy, Mummy, read me a bedtime story.
All right, settle down. This one's called The Rainbow Fish. There once lived a beautiful rainbow fish with scales of every color. One day, it met a very sad fish that only had gray scales. The rainbow fish knew the grey fish would be a lot happier if it too could swim around with beautiful colours. The rainbow fish ripped a scale from its body and...
Ah! 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 My altruism was my downfall! Ah!
Friday night ABC documentary, Cabinets of the World, we will explore intimate footage from the highest echelons of global governance. Up now, the Cabinet of Liechtenstein.
There must be something we can talk about. Surely there's a pothole somewhere?
Mr. Prime Minister! Mr. Prime Minister! Oh, there is a robbery happening at the Vaduz main bank!
Oh, this is the moment we've been preparing for! Yes? Yes?
Yes? You sure? Okay. False alarm, everyone.
The Cabinet of South Africa.
Mr. President, there is a large corruption scandal engulfing our government.
Tell the people Nelson Mandela founded our party.
Oh, great idea.
But there is massive income inequality facing the black population in South Africa.
Quote Nelson Mandela.
Oh, I did not think of that.
But the economic growth has slowed to a hunt.
You know what to do.
Use Nelson Mandela.
And never before seen footage from the Cabinet of North Korea.
In 2015, the Australian Federal Police adopted a new corporate plan with the motto to fight crime and win. Upon learning this, the ANU Law Review submitted a Freedom of Information request. This is a dramatic recreation of the documents uncovered.
Where are my officers?
Sir! Sir!
You are late!
Sir, actually, we are not late, we are 15 minutes early!
I'm your superior, where is your respect?
Sir, we apologise, our watches are very slow, we are indeed late.
Sir, actually, we're not late because my mum bought me a satellite watch and we are now 14 minutes 32 seconds early.
Excuse me, recruit, but are you contradicting me?
Sir, no, I'm not, sir!
She just did, sir.
Anyway, the Commissioner is in a particularly foul mood today. Do you know what that means?
It means you're also in a bad mood, sir.
No! It means that my neck is on the line if we do not implement the Commissioner's new slogan immediately. Do you remember what it is?
It does not matter how slowly you go as long as you do not stop.
Diamonds are a girl's best friend.
Just do it.
No! It is to fight crime!
To fight crime!
And win!
And win!
Which is it, sir? To fight crime or win?
To fight crime and win!
To fight crime!
And win!
Now, to implement this slogan, we need to eradicate all crime in this great country, starting with the ABC.
Very good, sir!
A noble goal! Sir, I have a question.
Yes?
About the new slogan, to fight crime.
And win, yes?
Very good, sir. A fantastic slogan. Very ambitious and heroic.
No disrespect, sir. I just have a personal dilemma, I suppose. A moral quandary, if you will. If we eradicated all crime in this great country, then what would we be needed for? We'd be out of a job.
You'll be out of a job if you don't follow orders from higher-ups.
Yes, sir.
I do not appreciate you contradicting me. I've high blood pressure.
Sorry, sir.
Yes, well, I suppose it's not your fault I have high blood pressure.
No, sir.
Anyway, you have your orders.
Fight crime and win!
Dismissed! Commissioner, sir!
Sarge, at ease, I've been thinking.
Congratulations, sir!
Thank you, Sarge. I have a personal dilemma, I suppose. A moral quandary, if you will. It's about the new slogan, to fight crime
and win! A very good slogan, sir. Very noble, very ambitious, very heroic.
Yes. It must be changed.
What?
Well, you see, Sarge, if we were to eradicate all crime in this great country, then we'd be out of a job. I'm sure you've realised this, Sarge.
Well, yes, of course.
Good, good. I'd be most displeased if such a careless idea were to have left this room. You haven't told anyone, have you?
No, I wouldn't dream of it.
Fantastic, Sarge. So I was thinking we could change the slogan to...
To...
Sir! Sir! Oh, Commissioner, sir!
Don't mind them, Commissioner! Off with you!
But, sir, we have report on the new slogan!
The new slogan?
Yes, we have... Stopped!
Stopped what?
We have killed...
Killed what?
Everything!
We fought all crime!
And won!
No!
Oh! sir?
Loved it. Amazing.
Very
hilarious.
They did so well.
What was your favorite part?
That's a very difficult question.
The Hamilton song was fantastic. Yeah. And Where It Happens, that was very good.
Too hard to choose. All of it.
Yeah, fantastic. Really good.
Loved it. Yep. This is our third one in a row.
Third one.
Yeah. And what was your favorite skit?
Skittles?
Yeah, we couldn't figure out what it was. We always loved it. Super niche. So amazing.
Very
so funny.
So funny.
Highly good.
Highly good.
Highly good.
What was your favourite skit?
The favourite one?
I'm being down.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I like the Skittles one. It kind of spoke to me.
How?
I don't know, but I felt that was good. It was like a metaphor for my law school. It's kind of law school. Just getting confused the whole time. That's how I felt about it.
Numbers.
What was your favourite skit?
I liked the French bit.
Yeah. The baguettes, yeah. That was good.
Spectacular. Brilliant. I'd recommend it anyway.
Very funny.
Yeah. And your favourite skit?
For me, I think the final call number from the Great Show.
And I liked the one about the Coombs seminar room.
It was really, really good.
Amazing.
I really loved it. The musical numbers were incredible.
They're all amazing individuals.
Incredible actors.
I love Ryan Street.
Ryan Street. Dan Griss. Don't stop on Dan Griss. Kate Garrow.
Sophie Talley.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Beautiful.
Love it. And your favorite skit?
I enjoyed the This Is Me / Law mashup.
That was pretty good, yeah.
The sports movie, yeah. I love the sports movie. Had me just feeling my Mighty Ducks nostalgia.
Very funny.
Yeah.
We came and saw Madeline.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, she was really good.
And favorite skit? Okay, early on, yeah.
I think mine was the underdog story.
Yeah, I was
fun. And your favourite skit?
Probably the French one.
The French one.
No, it takes the curve. That was hilarious. Hey, I would do the same thing.
Exciting. It was just fun to do it in front of an audience, yeah. Get some people laughing.
Yeah.
I think we can do even better the next two nights, yeah. But yeah.
And what was your favourite skit to be in?
I love Manic Sphere, the one where all the kids die.
It's going to go painful. No, it was fine. It was as painless as that Band-Aid coming off. Yeah, really good. It's really interesting. First time where I've seen, over the course of about a year, skits from paper to being in front of an audience. You don't get the reactions you expect, and it's good, it's bad, but it's good overall.
Yes.
Yeah. Awesome. Really good.
And your favourite skit in the show?
Favourite skit, Manix's Fear. The idea of school kids being in a war zone, as morbid as it sounds.
Really good, I think, I hope, hopefully.
Yeah? What's your favourite skit to be in?
I think Manix's Fear. It's really fun because everyone laughs so much, so it's nice.
Yeah. I thought it went really well. That last song was like, I'm still full of the exhilaration of it. Yeah.
And what's your favourite skit to do?
My favourite? I really like the Royal Crusader where there's like Bachman. I think that's really funny.
Yeah.
Like, it definitely could have gone worse.
Well, what's your favourite skit to be?
Shorten is a good one because it's a really tough balance because you want to be boring but not so boring the audience are actually bored. It's a tough gig. That or just doing an obnoxious South African accent.
I think it went pretty well for an opening night.
Yeah.
It's really exciting. I think we almost, if not, sold out the entire show.
Yeah.
So hoping that we sell out for the next few nights. It's looking like it.
Awesome. And what's your favourite skit to be in?
My favourite sketch to be in is to fight the Diamond Queen, where I get to play the really weird, strong, insecurely masculine sergeant within the AFP.
Yeah, great. It was lots of fun.
The audience seemed to really enjoy it, and we had a blast as a cast, so it was really good.
Well, what's your favourite skit?
What's my favourite skit? Probably Baroque Crusader, where we're joking about Bachman, which is very funny.
It was really, really fun. Energy was really good. Everyone laughed at things that we thought they would laugh at, and also things that we didn't think they would laugh at, which is really, really good. Opening night, the nerves are now gone.
Yeah. And what's your favourite skit?
Personally, I like External Affairs, but I think the audience really liked Maddox's Smear.
Yeah. What's your favourite skit to be in? What was your favourite skit tonight?
My favourite skit tonight was The Family Business.
Yes.
I was really invested in it. Yeah. I was like, I was so invested, and I was like, oh, people have to laugh at this. And I was like there being like, are they going to laugh? Are they going to laugh?
Yeah. Yes. And you got to do your Scottish accent again?
Yes, I did. Snuck it in there for one line. Yes,
that's great.
Performances tonight were lacking in intensity.
I think you should count in. I think you guys should cut out of the show. I think some people
can do a better job.
Yeah, actually. I think I'd be really good in
I think you'd be great in the office sketch, to be honest. And I reckon we cut out a lot of the sketches that were added in the line.
Yeah. What was your favorite role to perform, Matt?
Probably
External Affairs. That's fantastic.
I reckon.
I like being the rainbow fish. I get to die on stage.
I'm annoyed about how well that landed, because I hate that sketch, but it annoys me, because it's so funny, and that's why I hate it so much, because it is so funny.
When you're in the biz long enough, Tony, you know what people want.
That was an annoyingly well-received sketch.
Shout out to my friend Jonathan for coming from Sydney to see my show.
Thanks, man. What do you think of the show, Jonathan?
Fantastic. Yep. The school captain skit sort of looked like it came straight from the mind of Alex. It was a skit that I think could only have come from there. It was fantastic, and I'd say everyone should come and go watch the show.
Awesome. Thank you. Cheers. And we're back.
Oh, and also thanks to our amazing tech team.
Tech team. They've already declined interviews. They don't want to be on camera.
Stage manager.
I'm going to get sued over their footage.
It's good. It would look 1% as good without the lights and sound.
Yes.
Yeah. It looked otherwise.
You were happy with how it all went, though? Yeah.
Broadly. There's always room for improvement.
Yeah.
Got to be a perfectionist. Also, thanks to backstage guys. Thanks, Chris.
Awesome. Thanks.
When the call is you,
gonna make a phone call too.
Call the doctor feeling blue.
My anxiety's coming through.
Got my name and number here.
Gonna try and hold back that fear.
Remember just in time.
We'll call when you can book online.
Ring, 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 ring. Let it go until it rings out. Couldn't care less who or what it's about. Now put that mobile down.
Yeah, so my name's Ryan Street. I'm part of the Law Review 2019 cast, Law Review 2 WeTorts Resort. I'm very excited to be doing another show. This will be my third Law Review in a row.
Hi, I'm Maddie. I'm the producer of this year's show. Really, really excited for everyone to see it. We've been working really hard, dancing really hard, singing really hard, and we think it's going to be really funny.
Hi, I'm James. I'm technically the musical director of the show this year. I don't know if that actually means all that much.
Hi, I'm Minash Roussam, director of the Annual Law Review.
Hi, I'm Alex Merrick, one of the other directors of the Annual Law Review.
We're just here before the show, starting off. It's going to be pretty good, I think. If no one laughs, it'll be sad. But I think we're guaranteed at least two laughs.
Two laughs, yes.
Two laughs.
Hi, my name's Connor. I don't have any role in the Law Review except passive and probably disdainful observer.
Hi, I'm Alessa. I'm one of the cast members of Law Review this year.
And what's your role? You're just one of the cast in the cast?
Yeah, I do a bunch of different skits. I think I die twice and do at least three power poses. So it's a successful year all round for me.
Hi, I'm Emily and I'm the band captain for this year's Law Review. It's my second one. So I was in Law Review last year.
In the band again?
Yep, in the band. I play violin and this year's got banjo. So.
Hey, my name's Daniel Gross and my role in the Law Review is, well, a robot, a member of government, all sorts of things. A student as well.
An actor?
An actor.
Cast
an actor.
Member.
A writer, cast member, singer, dancer, everything.
Where's the rest
Jack of all
the
trades.
Jack of all trades.
Master of none.
But a mercurial something.
Yeah. Like the god, Mercury. I'm a god.
Hi, I'm Laura Pierce. I'm the stage manager of this year's show. And that's my job. No, I've been involved for the last 8 years. So I started off as an actor and then went through director and producer and they couldn't get rid of me. So I hung on as stage manager for the last few years.
Oh, I'm Beck Long and I'm in various sketches, I guess.
Yeah, I'm Sophie Tyler and I am also one of the cast members in so many sketches, so many characters.
Should
I can't remember them all. Yeah.
And how many law reviews have you guys been in?
This is our first, actually, for both of us. Yeah.
Yeah.
Debutantes.
So exciting.
Excellent.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts, feelings, emotions right now?
I'm so excited for an audience to see it. I can't wait to see their reactions. I hope they enjoy it as much as we enjoy.
I hope they appreciate how many costumes we changed.
Yeah, exactly.
Hi, I'm Claire, and I'm a follow spot for this show. So I'm back at the Lights team. I've never done an official law review before, only a Christian show. I'm very excited to finally be a part of the law review. Now that I have finally graduated and I'm no longer a student.
I'm not smart or astute, but I look great. It's a sports movie. Tears in my eyes when they hug at the end. A sports movie. How did they afford to pay for the prize? I got my first real six string, bought it at the Five and Dime, played it till my fingers bled.